What is the difference between Saguna Aradhana and Nirguna, Sarguna Dhyana and Nirguna Dhyana? Beautiful question. Every dhyana starts with Saguna Dhyana only. You cannot directly go to the Nirguna Dhyana. Saguna Dhyana, when you have a mantra, Soundarya. When you have a mantra, you start a dhyanam either with a mantra or a form or on the silent. If you start with the mantra or the form, then the guna automatically comes. And you will see her face, you see that she is pleased, you see that she is blessing. It's all Saguna Dhyana. Even in our pujas, completely it is Saguna Dhyana. In not only this, in the normal life, Saguna Dhyana is treating every human being as the Goddess Mother is called Saguna Dhyana. These are also form. Antar Bahitya Tattarvam Vyapyanarayana Sitaha. Instead of going to an icon and imagining some power in that, it is there. But you have to do a lot of practice to feel that power. Instead of that, if you worship, if you have the feeling of Goddess Mother in all these forms around you, not only human, the monkeys have come in the evening. Our people have fed all the bananas to the monkeys happily and they are eating. It is Saguna Dhyana. And slowly, this will lead you to the Nirguna Dhyana. Nirguna Dhyana is Antarmukha Samaradhyam Bahirmukha Sudurlabham. How I can put? When everything is fine, right? And the people are fine, they are in tune with you, you enjoy the Saguna Dhyana. That means you are worshipping their good nature, gunam. When the things are not working, then you go for the Nirguna Dhyana, where all pervading is Atman. I am not bothered about the form. I am not bothered about their action. It's an Atman. And then this Chatur Mahavakya, Aham Brahmatmi, Ayamatma Brahma, Prajnanam Brahma, Tattvamasi, are Ardham Jwalati Jyotiramasmi, Jyotir Jwalati Brahmahamasmi, Yohamasmi, Brahmahamasmi, Ahamasmi, Brahmahamasmi, Ahamevaham, Mam Juhomi Swaha. This is Nirguna Dhyana. That means, I'm not bothered about the external features or external characteristics of the people or forms around me, but I'm only focusing on that thing, Ardram Jwalati. That means the compassion of the Universal Mother in putting that person right before me, where I can see that lamp fire of knowledge in that person also as Atman. It is burning here, it is burning there, it is burning. So you go to that feeling like this electricity now is giving me light here, the fan is moving, the mic is working, like that. Sometimes the same mic can be disturbance for you. When the mic is joyful, you enjoy the mic and that's called Nirguna Saguna Dhyana. When the mic is disturbing you, well, the same current which is there in the mic now giving me the light. It's all the current that is all pervading. I enjoy the current. Go to the Nirguna Dhyana. Nirguna Dhyana means beyond the characteristics. But it is always Nirguna Dhyana which make you reach the ultimate. Like always, I told some time back, when you do the Dhyana before, the Dhyana Slokam will come. The Dhyana Slokam, even though it gives a form, Sindhurarana Vigraham Trinainam Manikyamodi Spurastarana Yudhekaram. Form. But beyond the form, if you are if you are alert, you can see the tattva, the feeling, the message coming from the form. You cannot get stuck to the form. So sagunam is there. From the sagunam, you go to the nirgunam. Sindhura, sacrifice. Aruna, knowledge. Sindhura, Navigraham, you are a personification of sacrifice and knowledge. Go to that. That doesn't have gunam. So, you do the dhyanam. Now you say the mantra. Kaihi la sreem, hatake la sreem, sake la sreem. Kaihi la sreem, hatake la sreem, sake la sreem. Kaihi la sreem, hatake la sreem, sake la sreem. It goes Vagbhav Kuta, Kamaraj Kuta, Shakti Kuta. Then it goes higher level. Kaihi la sreem, hatake la sreem, sake la sreem. Kaihi la sreem, hatake la sreem, sake la sreem. From this triangle, you meditate on that. Still you are in the Saguna Dhyana. Then, you forget the mantra. I mean, not forget, you lose the mantra. But actually mantra is going in anahata sound. You don't hear that. Because it is coming without your action, you don't feel that also. And at that time, the central, you know, the Sri Chakra triangle and the Bindu, the central point is activated. For different people, different experiences can come. Sometimes it can be like a flame coming. So it previously started with Saguna. It comes there, light burning or Tatillata, lightning. After that, Nishchalam. There is nothing. But then, in the Nirguna, the Saguna is also there. Kaihi la sreem, hasake la sreem, sake la sreem. Kaihi la sreem, it goes. Ajapa. This is the point where you need to experience. So, all the Saguna Dhyanam will end in Nirguna Dhyanam. And Nirguna Dhyanam is almost equal to Gunatita Stiti. That means there. Na mantram, na punyam, na babam, na tirtham, na mata, na vitu, na bandhu, na sakha, na punyam, na babam. Sat chit ananda surupam, sivoham, sivoham. Aham Sivaha. So, all this will go. One day, all of us who are doing this, to leave it. But like, you know the sugar cane, you put it in the machine, you crush it, you get the juice. After that also, you just chew that, you know, that junk. You don't. Once all the juice has come, to leave like that, once all the experiences of essence has come, then slowly it will, you don't leave, then slowly it will go on its own. And it will lead you to the Nirguna and then Gunatita. Gunatita is, how do you know that you are almost to that Nirguna direction? Not reaching, at least going in the direction. When you don't comment on the external behavior. When you don't react for the external behavior. This is the highest point. Whatever happens, Asuddha is there, still maintain. Suddha is there, still maintain. Job is gone, thank you. Job is given, thank you. You're not affected by the external behavior. This is also a state of Nirguna. Dharma, dharma vivedita, vivedita. Dharmayanama, adharmayanama, adhyananama, anishwarya. It's a state of existence and my mind stamps that with a quality, with a guna and saying this is suguna and this is durguna, this is sukarma, this is dushkarma. But finally, it's a karma. That's it. So, nirguna aradhana, Nirguna Dhyanam is not only thinking about God and going to the formless entity, but also in a practical life, accepting everything in the world without analysis. Visleshana rahita jivanam iti Sri Vidya sadhanam. Non-analytical approach towards the world is Sri Vidya. Non-analytical. World will be like this. Whether you do Sirshasan or a few Mahashodasi 15 lakh, world will not change. Maybe it will bring a change in you. That's all it can.